Sì, lo so che non c'è luce in una stanza quando manca il sole. Se non ci sei tu con me, con me. Sì, le finestre mostrano tutto il mio cuore che è acceso. Chiudi dentro me la luce che ho incontrato per strada.
Sogno all'orizzonte e manca le parole. Io sì lo so che sei con me, tu mia luna, tu sei qui con me. Mio sole, tu sei qui con me, con me.
Thanking a lot of people because it takes a lot of cooperation to put a show like this together. A whole lot of cooperation. Starting with the Castro Valley Unified School District, they own this building and they have given us the absolute privilege of having three to four exhibits a year without fees. So we are very grateful to them. And Parveen Ahmadi is the school superintendent. She is unfailingly supportive of art. Also, Sean Cooper, whenever there's anything wrong, it lands in his lap. And things like where we come in on Monday for intake and there's no dividing wall up. So, you know, just things like that. Okay, also Franco Giron and Jordan Hall are the two custodians from Castro Valley Elementary, and I want to give them a special shout out because they already have a full-time job, and we're extra. We're just one more little thing they get to do. So every time you come here and the door is still locked, it's because somebody just was doing something else over there and they just couldn't quite do everything at once. Jerry Thompson here has been a leader in this particular show, and we need to say thank you to him. And Jerry also is responsible for, along with Richard and Anne Maloney Mason, for putting up 78 artworks. That means 74 paintings and 4 sculptures. And from 42 artists. That's a lot of participation.
Beautifully hung.
And then, yes, it is beautifully hung. And Dan Fontes, where he was here a minute ago.
Oh, yes.
Okay, so he is our judge. And he has a job that I absolutely would not envy, having to look at this and think, okay, they all look
fun.
So good.
It's fun.
I'm glad you think it's fun.
It is. Well, it's hard work.
Also, Bev was here a minute ago. I want to say thank you to Bev Lindsay because she helped at intake for 2 days with Jerry and I. And when you take in 78 paintings, meetings. That's a lot of things to keep track of. We can't lose anybody's name and we can't spell it wrong. Wanted also to thank Susan Thompson, who is right here. In addition to being the secretary for Art Inc., she got all of our food, and she set it out with Molly Dolly and Cynthia Bragdon. And so they are responsible for this absolute beautiful piece. I just saw Pam Holloway. She is responsible for these colorful, beautiful signs that tell us that this is open for business. Things like this.
Yeah, great.
Yes, you notice that it's whimsical, it catches your eye, and she paints them. I think it's wonderful. Okay, so I would like to introduce you to also to the HARD Foundation support group with President Linda Cliff. And would you like to say a few words?
Sure.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much for inviting me. I'm a volunteer with the HARD Foundation. I'm currently the chair or the president. I will be finishing out my third term in December. And the foundation is the money-making, if you will, wing of HARD. So we try to do the fundraisers and the things that bring in money for HARD to open parks and do the things that they do. It's really an honor to be here today. And if you may have noticed, I have little buttons in there. I have invitations to our donor appreciation picnic on October 26th. We love to see you there. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Jerry Thompson, and thank again to Dan Fonts. He would like to talk with you if you have any questions for him after the award ceremony. He loves to talk to people, talk about art. And thank you for the HARD Foundation for funding this. They gave us all the money for the awards and paying for the judge, the food, and everything. I'd also like to point out that in the gallery we have a memorial for a lady, one of our members, Janice Moulton, who passed away last year. There's a picture of her and then two of her paintings on each side. So,
and an obituary.
Obituaries there as well. So we have 18 awards, honorable mention, merit awards. Myself and Winnie are going to give awards at the end in honor of our mothers. So let's get started. And I have the envelopes here, so when you come up to get your award, I'll hand the envelope to you. Check to make sure that the check's got the right name, your name on it. And if you can stand along the side here, maybe we could get a group photo at the end of everybody. And
could I throw in a thank you to our treasurer here?
Oh, Richard Geiger wrote the checks. And with the money, right.
who has writer's cramp from writing out all these bonus checks?
So without further ado, I will hand it off to Linda. When she reads your name, just come up. I'll give you the envelope, and if you can stay up here, we'll wait till everybody gets their award, then we'll take a group picture.
Thank you. So, welcome to the awards ceremony. We're going to begin with 12 honorable mention awards for $25. As Jerry said, when your name is announced, please come up and get your award and remain to have a picture taken. I'm going to call the award winner, the name of their art, and the comment from the judge. So we'll begin with Holly Adopmick. Holly did Stanley Chasm. The judge says it's a solid composition, great attention to dark and light exposure. All right. And let me just apologize right now if I get anybody's name wrong. Deborah Collins. Yay. Shot in the dark.
The beautiful story of youthful love is packed into this small space.
Terry Cordero, Monarch Butterfly?
She's not here.
But the judge said it was a delightful contrast of focused and blurred vision. Patricia Doyne? I know. Golden Range. Patient, quiet, busy, yet uncomplicated.
Susan Howell? She's not here.
Susan did the black and white cat lantern.
Oh, great.
Yeah. Uplifting, humorous composition. The artwork stands out in the crowd with its harlequin pattern. Dilip Nandwana?
I don't see Dilip.
Okay. He did iris flowers. Sustained sensitivity within the field of biological illustration. Julia Oversloot?
She's not here.
She is not here.
Oh my.
Angel's Trumpet Tree, exquisitely rendered study, great composition, leaving the viewer wanting more. Anna Maria Rodriguez?
Also not here.
She did a piece called Joyous. This is all about color. The strong foreground sets up the color contrast in the receding landscape. Charlotte Severin? She's here, yay! Charlotte did Surf Spray. Great sense of movement, tremendous realistic interpretation using abstract elements. Stan Sandelman? Rocky Mountain Water, strong composition with good water to landscape ratio and cool, warm color balance. And our very own Jerry Thompson. Late Summer, Lake Chabot. Great atmospheric depth, wonderful transition between representational and abstract expression. Doyle Wagner?
Also not here. Night Highway?
Orchestration of abstract elements including framing, good texture, both brief and studied in application of paint. Azar Vadkefi?
Not here.
His piece is called, her piece is called Joyful Garden, expressive color distribution in a pastel wonderland. And last is Cedric Williams. Fort Funston, Kissed by the Sun. And the judge says this hits all the marks of balance and depth with a strong representational foundation.
Next,
Winnie and Jerry will announce the Margaret Robbins and
Eufa Thompson
Awards in honor of their artistic mothers. Each is awarded $100.
Thank you, Linda. So, award for the Margaret Thompson Award goes to Pamela Holloway. Yay. I know we always love to serve tea parties to children of all ages. And this is perfect.
Thank you. Now,
Jerry. The final award, the Eufa Thompson Award, in honor of my artistic mother, is to Holly Adamic for Stanley Chasm.
Yay! Woo-hoo. Go, Holly, go! Wow. You rock!
Wow. All right, big winner, two awards. Wow. Highly contrasting canyon walls create this dramatic scene. Diagonal lines of the colorful canyon walls direct attention through the image. My mother loved nature and would appreciate the skill required to create this captivating image. Oh, and here's Robert Ribeiro, you won two awards. Come on up to the front. And just a note to the artists, I think we still have some spots on the calendar for gallery sitting?
In order to have our gallery open to the public, we have to have a staff, two people at a time, to be here. And right now, we have holes in our schedule. And I just happen to have the schedule with me, and I would just love to see you with your little pen filling your name at the hole, because you can bring something to work on, you can bring friends, you can announce it to your all your neighbors that you are going to be sitting here and we'll do a free docent tour. Do anything you can to let people know that this gallery is here and it's full of good things.
Should we get a group photo?
Yes.
Who's our photographers?